Students, welcome to the next topic. In this particular video, we will be discussing the silent feature of the Constitution. The silent features of the Constitution is divided into two parts. In the first part, we will be discussing the total 8 silent features, and in the part 2, the remaining 8 will be discussed. So let us start with the introduction. So the contents are introduction. Here we will see the introduction of the salient feature and the 8 salient features like lengthiest written constitution, drawn from various sources, blend of rigidity and flexibility, federal system with unitary bias, parliamentary form of government, synthesis of parliamentary sovereignty and judicial supremacy, integrated and independent judiciary and fundamental right. These salient features will be discussed in this particular discussion. Let us start with the introduction. The Indian Constitution is unique in its content and spirit. Though they borrowed from almost every constitution of the world, the Constitution of India has several salient features that distinguish it from the constitution of other countries. It should be noted that outset that a number of original features of the Constitution as adopted in 1949 have undergone a substantial change on account of several amendments, particularly 7th, 42nd, 44th, 73rd, 74th and 97th amendment. In fact, the 42nd Amendment Act 1976 is known as mini constitution due to the important and large number of changes made by it in various part of constitution. However, in the Kesavananda Bharati's case 1973, the Supreme Court ruled that the constitution power of parliament under Article 368 does not enable to alter the basic structure of the constitution. So let us see the different salient feature of the constitution. The salient feature of the constitution as it stands today are as follows. Very first is lengthiest written constitution. Constitution are classified into written like American Constitution or unwritten like a both constitution, British Constitution. The Constitution of India is the lengthiest of all the written constitution of the world. It is a very comprehensive, elaborate and detailed document. Originally 1949, the Constitution contained a preamble, 395 article and 8 schedule. Presently in 2016, it consists of preamble about 465 article divided into 25 parts and 12 schedules. The various amendments carried out since 1951 have deleted about 20 articles and one part 7 and added about 90 articles, 4 part and 4 schedules. No other constitution in the world has so many articles and schedule. 4 factors have contributed to the elephantine size of our constitution. They are geographical factor, historical factor, single constitution for both the center, and the dominance of legal luminaries in the constitution constituent assembly. The constitution contained not only the fundamental principle of governance but also detailed administration provision. Further, those matter which other modern democratic countries have been left to the ordinary legislation or established political convention have also been included in the constitutional document itself in India. The second is drawn from various sources. The Constitution of India has borrowed most of its provision from the Constitution of various other countries as well as from the Government of India Act 1935. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar proudly acclaimed that the Constitution of India has been framed after ransacking all the unknown constitution of world. The structural part of constitution is to large extent derived from Government of India Act of 1935. The philosophical part of constitution, that is fundamental rights and directive principle of the state principle, derives their inspiration from American and Irish constitution respectively. The political part of the constitution have been largely drawn from the British constitution. The other provision of the constitution have been drawn from constitution of Canada, Australia, Germany, USSR, now it is named as Russia, France, South Africa, Japan, and so on. The most profound influence and the material source of constitution in Government of India Act 1935, the federal scheme, judiciary, governors, emergency powers, the Public Service Commission, and most of the administrative details are drawn from this act. More than half of the provision of constitution are identical to or bear a close resemblance to the Act of 1935. The third feature is blend of rigidity and flexibility. So it is a combined effect of rigid. On one hand it is rigid, so on other hand it will be flexible too. So in which manner it is rigid and flexible, let us see. Constitution are also classified into rigid and flexible, as I said. A rigid constitution is one that requires a special procedure for its amendment, as for example, the American constitution. The flexible constitution, on the other hand, is one that can be amended in the same manner as the ordinary laws are made, as for example, the British constitution. So the American constitution is quite rigid. On the other hand, the British constitution is flexible. So the Indian constitution is blend of both the properties or the characteristics. The constitution of India is neither rigid nor flexible, but synthesis of both. Article 368 provides for two types of amendment. Some provision can be amended by special majority of parliament, that is 2/3 majority of members of house present and voting and majority, and some other provision can be amended by special majority of parliament and with the rectification by half of the total state. At the same time, some provision of the constitution can be amended by the simple majority of parliament in the manner of ordinary legislative process. Notably, these amendments do not come under Article 368. The fourth feature is a federal system with unitary bias. The Constitution of India established a federal system of government. It consists of all usual features of the federation, like two governments, division of powers, written constitution, supremacy of constitution, rigidity of constitution, independent judiciary, and bicameralism. However, Indian constitution also contains large number of unitary or non-federal features like strong center, single constitution, single citizenship, flexibility of constitution, integral judiciary, appointment of state government by the center, all India services, emergency provision, and so on. Hence, the Indian constitution have been variously described as a federal in the form of unitary in spirit and quasi-federal by K.C. Weirs. Then the fifth feature is parliamentary form of government. Constitution of India has adopted the British parliament system of government rather than American presidential system of government. The parliamentary system is based on the principle of cooperation and coordination between the legislative and executive organs, while the presidential system is based on doctrine of separation of powers between the two organs. Parliamentary system is also known as Westminster 10 model of government, responsible government, and the cabinet government. The constitution established the parliamentary system not only at center but also in the state. The features of parliamentary government in India are presence of nominal and real executive, majority party rule, collective responsibility of executive to the legislature, membership of the minister in the legislature, leadership of the prime minister or the chief minister, dissolution of the lower houses, Lok Sabha or assembly. Even though the Indian parliamentary system is largely based on the British pattern, there are some fundamental differences between the two. For example, the Indian parliament is not a sovereign body like a British parliament. Further, Indian states has an elected head, that is republic, while British states has a hereditary heads, that is monarchy. The sixth feature is synthesis of parliamentary sovereignty and judicial supremacy. The doctrine of sovereignty of parliament is associated with the British parliament, while the principle of judicial supremacy with that of American Supreme Court. Just as the Indian parliament system differ from the British system, the scope of judicial review power of the Supreme Court in India is narrower than that of what exists in US. This is because the American Constitution provides for a due process of law, against that the procedure established by the law contained in the Indian Constitution. Therefore, the framers of the Indian Constitution have preferred the proper synthesis between British principle of parliamentary sovereignty and the American principle of judicial supremacy. The Supreme Court, on the other hand, can declare the parliamentary law as unconstitutional through its power of judicial review. The parliament, on the other hand, can amend a major portion of the constitution through its constituent power. The seventh feature is integrated and independent judiciary. The Indian constitution establishes the judicial system that is integrated as well as independent. The Supreme Court stands at the top of the integrated judiciary system in the country. Below it, there are high courts and the state level. At the state level, under the high court, there are hierarchy of the subordinate courts, that is district court and other lower court. This single system of court enforce both the central laws as well as state laws. Unlike in the USA, where the federal laws are enforced by the federal judiciary and the state law are enforced by the state judiciary. The Supreme Court is the federal court, the highest court of appeal. The guarantor of the fundamental right of the citizen and the guardian of the Constitution. Hence, the Constitution has made a various provision to ensure its independent security of tenure of the judges. Fixed service condition for the judges, all expenses of the Supreme Court charged on the Consolidated Fund of India, prohibition on discussion on the conduct of judges in the legislature, ban on practice after retirement, power to punish for its contempt wasted in the Supreme Court, separation of judiciary from the execution, and so on. And the eighth feature is about the fundamental right. Part 3 of the Indian Constitution guarantees the 6 fundamental rights to all the citizens. Right of equality, right of freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational right, and right to constitutional remedies. So that's all for this video and discussion. Let us continue the remaining 8 feature in the second part of the silent feature of the Constitution.